Hi, I'm Janica, your .NET guru. Today, we're going to wrap up our talk about thread synchronization. In the .NET framework, synchronization options start from variable-specific synchronization choices, code block-specific options, to the more flexible developer-controlled options. The following list shows you the options starting from variable-specific to developer-controlled. The most variable-specific option is the interlocked class. The interlocked class allows the ability to do basic operations on variables that are primitive types. It provides for the following operations on primitive variables. Back to our examples of trucks. Interlocked synchronization is analogous to the loads that trucks carry. Only one truck can carry a load at a time, but loads can be dropped off, added to an existing load of another truck, or exchanged for a different load. A step up from that is reader-writer locks. Reader-writer locks allow only one write operation at a time, while still allowing multiple read operations. This is analogous to a CB radio. Only one tracker can talk at a time, while all other trackers can still listen. Next are monitors and mutexes. Monitors are code block specific, meaning you wrap the code that involves resource sharing with a log statement like this. This is like a toll bridge that only allows one truck to pass through at a time. The truck that gets there first is allowed to pass while all other trucks wait in line until the bridge becomes available. Mutexes are simply like monitors, but can be named and applied across multiple processes. Lastly, you have more flexibility and developer control with events and wait handles. Events and wait handles are like traffic controllers that use hand signals to conduct traffic. You can signal one thread to wait while another thread is executing resource-specific code. This wraps up our segment on thread synchronization. Hope you learned something today from your .NET girl. Bye-bye!